Hello friends, welcome back to our channel NEET Biology Expert. I am Dr. Parveen, your biology professor. In this lecture series, we are studying about reproduction in organisms in the class 12 syllabus. Okay, so in the last few lectures, we studied about asexual method of reproduction in the organisms, particularly in small animals or unicellular organisms. As a continuation of that, in this lesson 4, we are going to study about reproductive propagation in plants, that is called vegetative reproduction. I'm sure you might have studied this vegetative method of reproduction in plants during your plus one, right? So what is vegetative reproduction? This is an asexual method of reproduction in many plants, whereby the parent plant produces their young ones similar to that. That is called exactly the clone of the parent cell. Okay. Here there is no male or female and mating will be there. So only one parent, either a male or a female, that plant will produce the offsprings. So that is called vegetative method of reproduction. Okay. So this asexual method of reproduction, this term particularly, this asexual, we used to say for animals, small animals or unicellular organisms, simple organisms like amoeba, bacteria, unicellular algae like Chlamydomonas, if they exhibit this asexual method of reproduction, we used to tell that as asexual. But if the same thing happens in plants, we used to call them with a particular term called vegetative reproduction. That is, means this asexual reproduction occurring in plants. Okay, right. So vegetative reproduction is also called as vegetative propagation or vegetative multiplication or cloning. So all these names are similar. So this means that these is the vegetative method of reproduction in plants. Okay, you have three names for that: propagation, multiplication and cloning. So let us see the definition. What is vegetative reproduction? It is a form of asexual reproduction occurring in plants in which a new plant grows from a fragment of the parent plant or a specialized reproductive structure. So you should notice here, the young ones is growing from the parent or from a specialized part of the parent. The full parent is not going to be there. Only a particular modification. Either the modification will be in the stem or in the roots or in the leaves like this. Okay. So the modifications will be there. From the modified or the specialized reproductive structures, a new plant will generate. That is a method of reproduction in plants. Okay. So this unit of reproductive structures used in the propagation process are called vegetative propagules or diaspores. So this is very, very important, guys. You should remember what is the reproductive structure or reproductive unit in plants are called. The asexual reproductive units, they are called vegetative propagules. Propagules means they are like agents. These agents, they help the new plants to grow from it. Okay, or diaspores, right? Okay, so this plant propagation or plant replication can be sexual or asexual. So here we are going to study about only asexual method. So it can happen through the use of vegetative parts of the plant, such as leaves, stems or roots. Basically, this vegetative method of reproduction we can classify into two broad categories: natural vegetative reproduction and artificial vegetative reproduction. What do you mean by natural? It occurs naturally. There is no man-made thing involved. Okay, so that is called natural. So example for this is modification occurs in stem part, or modification occurs in the root part, or in some plants the modification occurs in the leaves part. Okay, the other side is artificial vegetative reproduction, where man-made things will be there. Man is involved in that kind of artificial reproduction, that we will study in another classes. Okay, so here in this lecture, we are particularly going to concentrate about the stem modification in the natural vegetative reproduction method. So basically, you see, the stem of a plant gets modified for its asexual method of reproduction. Not in every plant, in few plants. So this can be categorized into two types. One is called underground stem modification. Another group is called subaerial or creeping stem modification. Okay. So what are called underground stem? Examples for them are rhizomes, corms, tuber, bulbs, bulbils, suckers. These are underground stem modifications. An example for subaerial or creeping stems are runners, stolons and offsets. So all these things we are going to study in detail in this class, right? So let us go for the first one, rhizomes. What are rhizomes? Rhizomes are also called as creeping rootstock. What do you mean by creeping? Creeping means moving from one place to another, like crawling, creeping, creepers we used to say for some plants. No. So this is called creeping. So these rhizomes are horizontal underground plant stem capable of producing the shoot and the root system of a new plant. Understand? So this is horizontal. Horizontal means they run on the surface of earth like this. Okay. This is vertical. This is horizontal. So they are capable of producing both the shoot and also the root of a new plant. So rhizomes are particularly storage starch materials and proteins. You should remember this very important point. What are rhizomes? Rhizomes are used to store starches and proteins and enables the plant to perennate underground. What do you mean by this? These rhizomes are the structures where the plant store its nutrients like starch, proteins, whichever needed for its growth. They store it. It's like a stock. So when the conditions are favorable, from that stock, the new plant grows. Okay. So why plants have this type of modification? Because, for example, not every season is favorable for every plant, right? There are 12 months. We have 4 seasons. Some plants grow very well in winter seasons. Some grows very well in rainy season. Some grows during summer season like this. Okay. So when the season changes, the plants will not die immediately. Despite it stores its nutrients in a structure form called rhizome. So whenever the condition is favorable, from that rhizome, a new plant generates. Okay. So we have 3 very good examples for rhizomes. The first one is banana, where banana has a reduced underground stem called rhizome, which bear several buds. See, this is the rhizome of a banana. If you want a banana in your garden, you have to plant this part only. This is the rhizome. Okay. So this will have several buds. So what this rhizome contains? It contains the starch or the nutrients needed for the plants to grow. Right. That bulged portion is called rhizome. So once we plant this rhizome, from that arises the pseudo stem. This part is called pseudo stem of the banana. And from that the plant comes up. Okay. So this is an example for rhizome, banana tree. And what is the biological name for banana? Musa paradisiaca. That is the biological name. Right. The next very famous example for rhizome is ginger, that is Zingiber officinale. Ginger. See here, this is a ginger. You go to your kitchen and look at a ginger. You could see structure like this. This structures, these are called nodes. Okay. These are called nodes. The space between two nodes are called internodes. The space between two nodes are called internodes. Okay. So in this ginger, you can see small, small buds. These are called buds, and you could see many roots, short roots. They are called adventitious roots. So this is the basic ginger. Very good example for rhizomous ginger. So what happens? This rhizome is having the starch nutrients for the ginger. Okay. Even if it is dried, it will be there. So you take a ginger which is dried also and soak it in water and then plant it. What will happen? After a few days, it will start budding and you can see a new leaves coming up. Because how comes it happening? Because it is a rhizome. From the store nutrients, the from the bud parts the leaf starts to comes up, from that a whole plant will grow, right? So this is an example for rhizome. And similarly another example is there, that is called turmeric, curcuma longa, turmeric. It is also same like rhizome. See here, they also have nodes. These structures are called nodes. Okay, so similarly from this, these are the rhizomes. From the rhizomes the whole plant starts to grow, right? Fine. The next method of underground stem modification is called corms. Corms, what do you mean by corms? Corms are solid enlarged underground stems. You should remember here, they are enlarged. The size is very big, bulge. Unlike rhizome, this size is very much big. Okay, same. They also store nutrients. This is corm. Okay, this structure is called corm. They also store the nutrients and they have an outer papery leaves. This you could see, these are the papery leaves, very thin leaves. That is called papery leaves. And they have buds. This is called bud. So from the bud, the whole daughter plant will grow. Okay. So these are called corms. So example for corms are Amorphophallus, Colocasia. What is Amorphophallus? This is the tallest flower, world tallest flower, I think. The size is almost 2 times, 2.5 times compared to a human being. Okay, that much tall this flower is. Okay, this has this corms, the reproductive structure in the underground. So from that storm corms only the plant grows. Okay, a very common example which we could see in our kitchen is Colocasia. Colocasia, this is a very tasty vegetable, where you could see the outer scaly. This is the outer scaly covering. Okay, and you could see here, these are the buds. Okay, so when we plant this, from these buds, look here, terminal buds, and they have short roots also. So when we plant this from this corms, the whole plant will start developing. Okay, so corms, another example is Colocasia. And the third example is Freesia. Freesia is a very beautiful flowering plant, where you could see these structures are called the corms. These are the underground stem modification. So when we plant this, from these corms the plant part will come. Understand? So these are the example for corms. And the third method of reproduction by modified underground stem is called tubers. What are tubers? See, tubers, there are two types. One type of tubers arises from the stem and another type of tubers arises from the roots. Stem tubers, root tubers. Okay, since here we are studying about modifications of the stem, we are going to see about example for the stem tuber only. Example for root tuber is carrot, where if you see a carrot from the whole plant, you could see the it's from the root. That's called root tuber. Okay, stem tuber example is potato. Let us see what are stem tubers. Stem tubers grow from rhizomes, runners that swell from storing nutrients. They have buds over their body. They are called nodes or eyes. This is very important. So the tubers, they have eyes, some structures like this. So from that eye part the buds develop. Okay, so this is important. From the bud a new plant will come when you place it in the soil. Okay, see, example for underground stem tuber is potato. What is the biological name for potato? Solanum tuberosum. See, the species name itself is telling, tuberosum. Okay, see here, this is a potato wherein you could see the eyes. These small dimples are called eyes. From that will germinate eye buds. These are eye buds. Okay, when we plant this potato, it will germinate. Another famous example for tubers is yam. Yam is also same like potato. Understand? So potato and yams are the example for tubers. And the fourth one, underground stem, is bulbs. What are bulbs? Bulbs are swollen part of the stem within which lie the central shoots of new plants. See, example for bulb is onion. Onion is a very good example. You go to your kitchen, take one onion, make a cut. Okay, you could see a green part like this. This is called the shoot of this onion. Okay, central shoot. So this part will rise into a new plant. Okay, so in order to give nutrients to the plant part, we have this fleshy scales. Understand? So it is the bulb like structure where in the central part is having the shoot. From that a new plant will come arise, and to protect the shoot and to give nutrients to the shoot, we have this white area which carries the all the nutrients, right? So they are typically underground and are surrounded by plump and layered leaves that provides nutrients to the new plants. You see here in the onion, we peel off the pink color, no, that parts are called the old leaves. So as you peel off two through layers of the old leaves, you will have the fleshy part. They are the fresh scaly leaves which gives nutrients to the shoot part. Okay, so onion bulb will be like this. So when you seed this in the soil, it will grow with roots. Okay, so example for bulbs are onion and garlic. And fifth method of underground stem modifications, example is bulbils or bulbils. Okay, either way we can call. What are bulbils? Bulbils are small young plants reproduced vegetatively from axillary buds on the parent plant's stem. So they are very small plants. From the parent plant, axillary buds will arise which give rise to the new plant. See, this is an agave plant. This agave plant is an example for bulbil. So if this is the plant, you can see here these are the small buds. So these buds develop and grow into an adult. Okay, it will be like totally a mass of plant. So both the parent and the daughter will be together near. Okay, so this is an example for bulbil, agave, right? And the sixth type of underground stem modification is called suckers. So what are suckers? Suckers arises from the base of aerial shoot with slender underground branches. This is important. Slender underground branches, and they grow for some distance and forms new aerial shoots. Look this picture. The example for sucker is chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum is a nice flowering plant. See, this is one plant, okay, and this is another plant. In between these two plants, there is one slender structure. You see here, this has many roots. Okay, so this structure is called sucker. Understand? So in between two plants, you have a connection. That structure is called sucker, and this sucker is slender and it is underground with branches. Okay, so that is called suckers. Example for suckers are, first example is chrysanthemum, a flowering plant. Second example is mint, pudina. Okay, mint leaves. See here, generally we used to cut this part of the leaves, mint only. Okay, so when you take completely from the root, you could see there is a connecting stem, underground stem, this structure. Okay, here they have short roots. Okay, so this is sucker, mint and chrysanthemum. Understood? Okay, so far we have seen underground stem modification: rhizome, corms, tubes, sucker, bulbs, bulbils and all. The next category is subaerial stem modification. What is subaerial? The stem modification will be there but above the ground level, little above the ground level. That is called subaerial stem. So this has three basic structures, that is called runners, stolons and offsets. So the first one is runners. What are runners? Runners are green, narrow, horizontal branches which develops at the base of the crown and root at the interval where new crowns are also formed. What do you mean by this? See, this is one plant. This is another plant. Okay, so in between these two plants, see here, this area is actually called crown. Crown of the plant means from that crown only the shoots will appear and also the root will appear. Okay, so here there is one connection. This structure is called runners. Then you can ask me, what is the difference between sucker and runner? We have seen sucker, no? That is underground. This is aerial. Okay, so that is the major difference. So this is a connection between two plants at a certain interval. The connecting stem part is called runner. So example for runners, subaerial runners or oxalis. This is a plant where we could see like this, and also here another example is Sentinella asiatica. In this picture you could see, see outside we can see only this, okay, and this part will be there on the soil, above the soil only, but it will be behind the leaves. So you could see here these connections, are called runners. Okay, another favorite example is lawn grass. When you pluck the grass, it will not come individually in this type of lawn grass. Okay, so it will come like a mat like structure. So that mat network connection in that in between the grass, these structures, see he is holding, no, these connections, these are called runners. Okay, and similarly this plant Ajuga rectens, these are all examples for runners. Understood? The second modification of subaerial stem is stolons. What are stolon? Stolon are arched horizontal branches. They develop at the base of the crown. They also help in the vegetative reproduction, same like runners. Same. See, we have seen runners, no? Same. Same as stolon. What is only one difference? Above the ground level, if it is flat, horizontal, this you call as runner. Above the ground level, that is subaerial, if it is like this, arched, then you call this as a stolon. Very simple. Okay, stolon, see here, it is arched like this structure, this is called stolon. Same like runner, two plants are there, and from the two plants there is a connection. This connecting line is called stolon. This is a stem modification. So example for stolon is strawberry plant. Okay, strawberry plant is a very good example for stolon. And Vallisneria, see here, the strawberry plant is covered, so we could not able to see this in this picture. But in this picture, you can see the arches. See here, the connection between individual plants, some arch-like connection. These are the stolons. Clear? Next, the third example for subaerial stem modification is called offset. What is offset? These are also internode long runners that occurs in some aquatic plants, and each offset could develop into a new plant. See, this is the structure picture from the NCERT book, where you could see one plant, water plant, okay, and another water plant in between a connection. This is called offset. Now you have a confusion between runners, stolon, offset. Okay, don't get confused. Runners means runners and stolons. These two are subaerial stem. Okay. So if it is flat, I told you, no, over the soil, runner. If it is arch, stolon. Same thing, same like runner. If it is in the underground water, it is called offset. Okay. So where you see offset, you could see offset in the water plants. Okay. So example for water plants is, one example is water hyacinth. Water hyacinth, this is a very beautiful flowering plant. So outside it will look like a mesh, and underground in the water they get connected with this offset. The another example here, you could see water lettuce. See, this plant is potted in a pot only. It's a water plant. Okay, so outside you could see individual plant like this, but when you see above the water, below the water level, you could see here this connecting part. This connecting part is called offset. Actually, it is stolon only, but it is in the water. So we give this name offset. Understand? Clear? Okay. So let us go for the recap. In this asexual method of reproduction, that is called vegetative reproduction in plants, we can classify them into two categories: natural method of vegetative reproduction and artificial method. Okay, so natural method occurs by modifications in the plant stem, root and also in the leaves. So in this lecture we studied only the modification which occur in the stem. It is classified into two categories: underground stem modification, subaerial or creeping stem modification. Okay, so example for underground stem modifications are rhizomes, corms, tuber, bulbil, bulbils, suckers. Okay, subaerial stem or creeping stem modifications are runner, stolons and offsets. Okay, so very easy guys, you write down each types and write down the examples for each one. I have told you some clues, no? So how it will be, how the structures will be like this. So you note down the clues and study. It's very easy. Okay, so in the next lecture we are going to study about the other modifications in the plants, that is root and leaf modification. So that will be our next lecture. So hope you like this lecture guys. If you like, please give a like and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon so that whenever we put new videos it will reach you immediately. Share this with your friends and see you in the next video. Until then, take care, bye.